Hello friends, welcome to my channel Civil Engineering MCQ. In this video, we will discuss about most important multiple choice questions in fluid mechanics and machines engineering. This video helpful for PWD, WRD, RRB, JEE, MIDC, ZP exam, and it is also helpful for various competitive exams. So let's start. Question number first, a single speed centrifugal pump feeding a small water supply distribution system of a block of house works at. This question is asked to exam PWD 2018. So correct answer option B, reduced efficiency. Number 1, answer is B, a single speed centrifugal pump feeding a small water supply distribution system of a block of house works at reduced efficiency. So right answer is option B. Question number 2. In which of the following situation the viscous force is unimportant? This is also question PWD 2018. So correct answer is option A, capillary waves in channels. Question number 2. Answer is A, a capillary wave's viscous force is unimportant because capillary is independent on viscosity of liquid. Second, viscosity is nothing but resistance to flow of liquid, whereas capillary is size or fall liquid due to a surface tension. Here is the correct option is A. Question number 3. Bowden's tube pressure gauge is an example of. So right answer option D, mechanical gauge. Question number 4. For maximum velocity, the hydraulic mean depth is equal to how much times the diameter of circular channel? For this question, option A, 0.3 is the right answer. Question number 4, answer is A, for maximum velocity in circular channel, 0.3 multiply diameter of circular channel equal to hydraulic mean depth 0.3d equal to r, where d equal to diameter of circular channel, r equal to hydraulic mean radius equal to area of channel upon weighted perimeter. So right answer option A. Question number 5. Water is flowing through a pipe with theoretical velocity 44.29 meter per second. If the coefficient of velocity is 0.95, the actual velocity of water is. Correct answer option D, 42.08 meter per second. Question number 5th, answer is D. This problem all values are, only one values are unknown. Given data, theoretical velocity equal to 44.29 meter per second, coefficient of velocity equal to 0.95. Find out actual velocity of water. Use this formula, coefficient of velocity equal to actual velocity or practical velocity upon theoretical velocity. So keep these values, 0.95 equal to V upon 44.29, cross multiply do it, V equal to 0.95 multiply 44.29, your values come 42.08 meter per second. So correct answer is option D. Question number 6, capillary of any liquid is independent of. So right answer is option B, viscosity of the liquid. Question number 6, answer is B. In capillarity, capillary rise or fall depends upon capillary rise or fall H. In this formula, H equal to 4 sigma cos theta upon rho GD equal to H equal to 4 sigma cos theta upon gamma D. The weight of substance per unit volume in absolute units equal to the density multiplied by the acceleration of gravity. So, multiply the density by the acceleration of gravity equal to 9.81. Where sigma equal to surface tension of liquid, theta equal to angle of contact between liquid and boundary, gamma equal to specific weight of liquid, and the last one diameter of tube. So correct answer option B. Question number 7. As we go at higher and higher altitudes, the absolute humidity. Here is the option D is the right answer. 7th answer is D. As we 90 higher altitudes, the absolute humidity is decrease. Question number 8. The bottom edge of notch is known as. Correct answer option C, seal. Question number 8. Answer is C. First one, nap. Free flow of liquid jet is called nap. Second one, seal. The bottom edge of notch is known as seal. Third one, wear. A masonry structure constructed in a channel to raise water level in channel. So correct answer option C. Question number 9. Which of the following statement is true? So correct answer option C. Specific weight of liquid remains constant at every place. Number 9. Answer is C. Specific weight equal to weight upon volume equal to mass into gravitational acceleration upon volume. So multiply the density by the acceleration gravity is 9.81. Question number 10. Which of the following types of loss is categorized differently from the other three losses in pipe? So correct answer option A. Loss due to friction. Number 10. Answer is A. Losses in pipe can be classified in: there are two types of head losses in pipe flow system, major head loss and minor head loss. There are only one types of losses that contribute to loss of due to pipe's friction. Minor losses. There are four types of losses that contribute to the first one, loss due to sudden expansion of pipe, second one, loss due to bend in pipe, third one, loss due to obstruction in pipe, and the last one, loss due to sudden contraction of pipe. So correct answer is option A. Question number 11. If in a liquid the metacentric is below the center of gravity of the body, floating body will be in. So right answer option B, unstable equilibrium. Number 11, answer is B. There are three conditions of equilibrium condition. First one, stable condition. Second one, unstable condition. And last one, neutral conditions. Okay, floating body will acquire a stable condition M lies above G. Submerged body will acquire stable condition B lies above G. Unstable condition, floating body will acquire M lies above G. Then submerged body will acquire B lies below G, neutral M and G coincidence and B and G coincidence, where M equal to meta center, G equal to center of gravity and B of center of buoyancy. So correct answer option B. Question number 12. Cavitation phenomena is caused by. So here is the correct answer option C, vapor pressure. Question number 12. Answer is C. If minimum absolute pressure inside a liquid falls below vapor pressure, cavitation start. Hence, cavitation is caused by vapor pressure. So correct answer option C. Question number 13. In an ogee weir, the crest of weir rises up to maximum height of weir, h equal to height of water above inlet of the weir. So correct answer is option C, 0.115 h. Question number 13. Answer is C. In an ogee weir, the crest of the weir rises up to a maximum height of 0.115 h. Question number 14. If at the inlet of the turbine, the water possesses kinetic energy as well as pressure energy, the turbine is known as. So correct answer option B, reaction turbine. Number 14. Answer is B. At the inlet of turbine, water possesses only kinetic energy for impulse turbine, whereas kinetic energy as well as pressure energy for reaction turbine. So correct answer option B. Question number 15. If stream function phi exits, it is a possible case of fluid flow which? So correct answer option D, may be rotational or irrotational. Number 15. Answer is D. The existence of stream function indicated the flow is incompressible. It may be steady or unsteady. Similarity, it may be rotational or irrotational. Correct answer D. Question number 16. Ogee spillway is an example of. This question is asked to exam Mahabij 2019. So correct answer option A, overflow spillway. Question number 17. Center of pressure dash the center of gravity of the vertical surface. This question is asked to exam PWD 2018. So correct answer option C, lies below. Number 17. Answer is C. The formula for center of pressure is y bar equal to ig sin square theta upon a y bar plus y bar, where y bar equal to distance of cg of body from free surface level of liquid. Ig equal to moment of inertia of the immersed surface about horizontal axis through its center of gravity. A equal to area of immersed surface. Hence, center of pressure lies below the center of gravity of the vertical pressure. So correct answer option C. Question number 18. The Pelton turbine is. So right answer option B, tangential flow impulse turbine. Number 18, answer is B. The Pelton turbine is high head, low disk, low specific speed, tangential flow, impulse turbine. So correct answer B. Question number 90. If the head of liquid from the center of orifice is more than dash times depth of orifice, it is called a small orifice. So correct answer option C is 5 times the depth of orifice is called in small orifice. Number 90, answer is C. For small orifice, head greater than 5 depth. Question number 20. Compressibility is the reciprocal of. The correct answer option C, bulk modulus. 20, answer is C. Compressibility and bulk modulus are inversely proportional with constant as a 1. So, compressibility is reciprocal of bulk modulus. So, correct option C. Question number 21. If velocity gradient of a fluid's flow is 10 units and dynamic viscosity is 2 units, then shear stress is units. So right answer option C, 20 units. Question number 21. Answer is C. This problem all values are given. Only one values are unknown. Find out shear stress. So use this formula. Keep these values. Tau equal to mu into du upon dy. Tau equal to 2 into 10 equal to 20 units. So correct answer C. Question number 22. Which one of the following statement is true for pumps operating in parallel? So correct answer option A, discharge increases. Question number 22. Answer is A. For pumps in parallel, head remains same. Total disc is sum disc of individual pumps. For pumps in series, disc remains same. So correct answer A. Question number 23. Which one of the following is reason for cavitation? So correct answer option A, low pressure. Question number 23. Answer is A. When pressure falls below vapor pressure, then cavitation starts. Question number 24. In which of the following axial flow reaction turbine vanes are fixed to the hub and are not adjustable? So correct answer option B, propeller turbine. Number 24, answer is B. In propeller turbine, blade are fixed at hub, whereas in Kaplan turbine, blade pivoted at hub. Both are similar in construction. So correct answer B. Question number 25. Through which one of the following property regain of strength with time is possible in soil mass? So correct answer option C, thixotropy. Question number 25, answer is C, thixotropy. It is the property of soil in which soil regains its strength and which loss in sensitivity. So correct answer option C. Question number 26. Loss of head at the entrance of pipe where V is F, velocity of liquid in pipe, and G is acceleration due to gravity is given by. So right answer option A, 0.5 V square upon 2G. Question number 26. Answer A. There are three types of pipe losses. First one, major losses, friction losses. Second one, minor losses. Third one, loss of head. Different formulas, pipe losses. First one, at entrance of pipe, 0.5 V square upon 2G. Second one, at sudden expansion, V1 minus V2 square, bracket square, upon 2G. At sudden contraction, 0.5 V square upon 2G. At exit of pipe, V square upon 2G. So correct answer option A. Question number 27. Stroke is the CGS unit of. So right answer option B, kinematic viscosity. Question number 27. Answer is B. Stroke is the CGS unit of kinematic viscosity. 1 stroke equal to 1 cm square upon S equal to 10 raised to minus 4 meter square upon S. Question number 28. Which of the following statement is true? First one, pressure head equal to total head minus kinetic head minus datum head. Second one, kinetic head equal to total head minus pressure head minus datum head. Last one, datum head equal to total head minus kinetic head minus pressure head. So right answer option D, first, second and third. Number 28, answer is D, total head equal to datum head plus pressure head plus kinetic head. Question number 29. For a viscous fluid flowing in circular pipe, the average velocity is 5 meter per second. If the diameter of pipe is 0.1 meter, then maximum velocity of fluid at given cross section is. Here is the right option is B, 10 meter per second. Question number 29, answer is B. Use this formula for laminar flow through circular pipe, maximum velocity V equal to 2 into average velocity. To keep these values V equal to 2 into 5, V equal to 10 meter per second. So correct answer is B. Question number 30, which one of the following device is used to measure pressure in a pipe? Here is the right answer, option B, manometer. Number 30, answer is B, pitot tube measuring velocity in channel, manometer measuring pressure, venturimeter measuring discharge, anemometer measuring wind velocity and direction. So correct answer B. Question number 31, the dimension of Chagee's constant is? Here is the right option A, L half T minus 1. Number 31, answer is A. Use this formula, Chagee's constant C equal to C under root of RS, where R equal to hydraulic radius in meter, S equal to bed slope, M upon S equal to C under root of M into 1 converted into unit, M upon S equal to C M half, M upon S into M half equal to C, M half upon S equal to L half T minus 1. So correct answer A. Question number 32. Two pipes are connected in parallel with fluid flowing through them. If the loss of head in one branch H, the loss in other branch is? Here is the right option B, H. Question number 32. Answer is B. When pipes connected in parallel, loss of head is remains same, but discharge is different. When pipe connected in series, loss of head is different, but discharge is same. So correct answer B. Question number 33. Which of the following device is used for measuring the velocity of flow at any point in a pipe? So correct answer option C, pitot tube. Number 33. Answer is C, venturimeter measured discharge, orifice meter measured discharge, pitot tube measured velocity. So correct answer option C. Question number 34. If velocity potential phi satisfy the Laplace equation, it represent. Correct option A, possible steady and irrotational flow. 34. Answer is A. If velocity potential phi exits the flow of irrotational, if it is satisfied Laplace equation, then the flow is incompressible. Hence, answer should be incompressible and irrotational. No such option is present. So correct option A. Question number 35, usability wear is an example of? Correct option C, trapezoidal wear. Number 35, your answer is C, usability wear is the trapezoidal wear. Question number 36, which one of the following represents the unit of dynamic viscosity of a fluid? Correct answer option A, Newton second per meter square. Question number 36, answer is A. The formula for dynamic viscosity is mu equal to tau upon du into dy, where mu equal to coefficient of dynamic viscosity, du upon dy velocity gradient, meter per second upon meter, tau equal to shear stress Newton per meter square. Above formula converted into unit, mu equal to Newton per meter square upon meter per second upon meter equal to Newton per meter square into meter upon meter per second equal to Newton per meter square into Sm upon meter, unit of mu equal to Newton per second upon meter square. Question number 37, Mach number is? Here is the right option B, ratio of fluid velocity and velocity of sound. Number 37, answer is B, root number equal to inertia force upon gravity force, Mach number equal to inertia force upon velocity of sound, Reynolds number equal to inertia force upon viscous force, and Weber's number equal to inertia force upon surface tension. So correct answer option B. Question number 38. In which one of the following axial flow reaction turbine vanes are not fixed to the hub are adjustable? So correct answer option C, Kaplan turbine. Question number 38, answer is C. In Kaplan turbine, vanes are not fixed to the number and adjustable. Question number 39, in laminar flow, right answer option A, all the stream lines are straight and parallel. Question number 39, answer is A. In laminar flow, all the streaming are straight and parallel. Question number 40. Steady flow is defined as that type of flow in which fluid characteristics like velocity, pressure, density at a point does not change with, correct option B, time only. 40. Answer is B. Steady flow, in which flow characteristics like velocity, pressure and density does not change with time only. Uniform flow, in which fluid characteristics like velocity, pressure and density does not change with space only. So correct answer, option B. Question number 41. For a broad crested weir, h equal to height of water above the crest, h equal to head of water at the middle of weir, the discharge to be maximum. So correct answer, option B, h equal to 0.67 h. 41. Answer is B. For broad crested weir, h equal to 0.67 h. Question number 42. Water is flowing through a 200 mm diameter circular pipe having coefficient of friction F equal to 0.04. The Reynolds number of the flow considering viscous flow is, right answer, option C, 400. Question number 42. Answer is C. For laminar flow through circular pipe, use this formula, coefficient of friction F1 equal to 16 upon Re. So keep this value, 0.04 equal to 16 upon Re equal to 16 upon 0.04 equal to 400. Your answer come equal to 400. Reynolds number Re equal to 400. Question number 43. In a liquid droplet spherical, if the diameter of droplet is increased, then the pressure intensity inside the droplet will keep other parameters unchanged. Right answer, option B, increase. Question number 43. Answer is B. Pressure inside the droplet P equal to 46 upon D. If diameter is decreased, pressure increased. Question number 44. 1 stroke is equal to, correct answer, option A, 10 raised to minus 4 meter square upon s. Question number 44. Answer is A. 1 stroke equal to 1 centimeter square upon s equal to 10 raised to minus 4 meter square upon s. Question number 45. The dimension of surface tension and capillarity are, correct option B, m1, t-2, l respectively. Number 45. Answer is B. Use this formula, surface tension equal to force upon L equal to Newton upon meter, kg into meter upon S square upon M equal to kg upon S square into 1 upon M equal to kg upon S square equal to M1 T minus 2 equal to M and T, capillarity N equal to M equal to L. So correct option B. Question number 46. In a turbine system, the shaft power obtained is 500 watt and overall efficiency is 0.5 watt water power. Correct option A, 1000 watt. Question number 46. Answer is A. Use this formula, overall efficiency mu equal to shaft power upon water power. So keep these values, 0.5 equal to 500 upon water power. Water power equal to 500 upon 0.5 equal to 1000 watt. So correct answer, option A. Question number 47. The dimension of surface tension is, right answer D, mt-2. Question number 47. Answer is D. Use this formula, surface tension equal to force upon length equal to Newton upon meter, kg into meter upon S square upon m equal to kg into meter upon S square into 1 upon m equal to kg upon S square equal to m1 t-2 equal to m and t. So correct answer, option D. Question number 48. Which one of the following statement is true for a pumps operating in series? Correct answer, option C, head increases. Question number 48. Answer is C. For pumps in series, head changes but discharge constitutions. For pumps in parallel, head constitutions but discharge changes. So correct option C. Question number 49. The most economical section of channel should have, correct option A, maximum discharge, minimum weighted perimeter. Question number 49. Answer is A. The channel having maximum discharge with minimum weighted perimeter is called most economical channel section. Question number 50. If the water flows along the tangent of the runner, the turbine is known as, correct option C, tangential flow turbine. Number 50. Answer is C. If the water flows along the tangent of the runner, the turbine is known as tangential flow turbine. Correct option C. Question number 51. Which one of the following devices is used to measure discharge in a pipe? Correct answer option C. Venturi meter. Question number 51. Answer is C. Pitot tube measures velocity. Manometer measures discharge. Venturi meter measures discharge. Anemometer measures wind velocity and direction. So correct option C. Question number 52. If the water flows radially from inwards to outwards, the turbine is known as. Correct option B. Outward radial flow turbine. Question number 52. Answer is B. If the water flows radially from outwards to inwards, turbine is known as inward radial flow turbine. If the water flows radially from inward to outward, the turbine is known as outward radial flow. Correct option B. Question number 53. If velocity potential exists, the flow should be. Correct option C. Rotational. Here this video is finished. I hope this video will be helpful for your exam. For more updates, subscribe to my channel and don't forget to share this video with your friends. Thank you so much.